What are superbugs? Let me start with a quote from Charles Darwin. He said, "It's not the strongest of species or the most intelligent ones that survive, but the ones that can quickly adapt changes with." Bacteria are single-cell species that are similar to us, animals and birds. They're the first species on Earth and have lived here for billions of years. Bacteria needs food, water, air, and to survive, but are continuously multiplying. They live for only 15 to 20 minutes. They are tiny, lived on us, and are now exploiting our genetic vulnerability with lethal precision. They are stronger and more intelligent, and are now armed with plasmid. What are plasmids? Soon after we started using penicillin in 1950s, bacteria called Staphylococcus started collecting information and developed resistance. This was reported in 1960s. These bacteria created a database of all the chemicals, including antibiotics, and stored them in a little envelope called plasmid. So any bacteria that has plasmid can be called a superbug. The superbugs pass on the plasmid to their babies, are also picked up by friendly bacteria and viruses or fungus that are living nearby after this bacteria dies. Let me explain this better. Superbug is like a madman who's picked up a gun from a dead man and is now running around like a headless chicken, behaving like a terrorist, killing people. Now we have 18 bacteria, funguses, parasites and numerous viruses that are armed with plasmid and are waiting to attack us. Are bacteria developing resistance faster than we can invent them? Certainly yes. Since 1970, we have not spent time or money to continue our research and develop new antibiotics or methods to fight infection. Now we are desperately trying to find alternatives but are failing miserably. We have not understood what information is stored in the plasmid and how these bacteria use this information to defend themselves from strong chemicals or antibiotics we throw at them. How can we prevent infection spreading? Infections spread directly or indirectly. Directly via water, food, air and contact. Indirectly using a vector like mosquito, animals or birds. We must stop drinking contaminated water, food and stay away from infected people and animals. If mosquitoes, cockroaches, rats, birds, bats are transmitting the infection, we must try and eradicate. I think we must first learn to live and let live. In other words, stop using antibiotics, strong chemicals to clean hospitals, homes, our body, and help friendly bacteria to thrive and help us fight superbugs. Isolation of infected patients using their symptoms is probably the best method to help us fight infection and save lives. What are symptoms? Symptoms are body's normal response to an insult. This is what we call as inflammation. Inflammation is a normal reflex that helps protect our body from physical and psychological traumas inflicted upon us. When a bacteria enters our body, first our body temperature will go up to help kill bacteria that are entering. Our heart starts beating faster to send an army of white blood cells to fight and kill bacteria that is entering our body. If the infection is on the skin, you will notice local swelling, redness, and you also experience pain. Diseases are name given to conditions based on combination of symptoms and signs. When you visit a doctor, they will first ask you a few questions. Based on the question, they will derive at a hypothetical diagnosis of an illness. They may call it arthritis, tonsillitis, bronchitis, or just a viral infection. If the combination symptoms are common, they often advise or prescribe antibiotics if necessary. If the symptoms are not common, they will clinically examine you and identify signs, request blood tests, scan, x-ray to confirm their hypothetical diagnosis. If the symptoms are serious, they will immediately refer you as an emergency to a hospital or a specialist. How can Dr. Maya app help people? I created Dr. Maya to work as an assistant. Maya requests you to identify three symptoms. Using this combination, Maya will differentiate common from serious illness and share information, advise you to speak to a doctor, book an appointment, or advise you to go to a hospital as an emergency. How can Maya help prevent pandemic? When you choose three symptoms, Maya will differentiate infection from a non-infectious disease. Our server will work as a monitor of symptoms to track clusters of symptoms occurring in an area, in a hostel, hospital, town hall, and inform local doctors, alert infectious disease control department to help isolate infected patients and help them impose quarantine to prevent spreading this infection locally. What alternatives do we have? Unfortunately, we have none. There's only one antibiotic on phase 1 trial that may be available 10 years later. One antibiotic cannot kill 18 types of bacteria. In other words, we will have to invent 18 new antibiotics to fight these infections. The more chemicals we throw at them, stronger they become. I think the only option, probably the best one available, is Dr. Maya. It quickly identifies individuals with infection and helps us to isolate them so that the family and friends and local people are not infected. We know partial exposure to bacteria or virus help us develop herd immunity. People living at home, community, county will develop immunity to protect themselves from superbugs. Where can we get Dr. Maya from? Dr. Maya can be downloaded from Google Play or Apple Stores. It's free to download and very easy to use. Using Dr. Maya, you can create a local group of doctors and patients. You can also order my book, Maya Brings Tears of Happiness, or Maya Fighting Infections, Saving Life, from Amazon.